I'm going to do a quick foam roller and mobility workout with you. A lot of times this is the way I start my day or before I'm gonna teach a class, especially if I'm really, really tight. But you can foam roll and you can do mobility whenever you want. You can do it before your workout. Sometimes I do it at night when I'm watching TV when I know I feel tight. Doesn't take a long time. So this is my foam roller. This is actually called a trigger point. I have no connection with this company. I just like it. My trainer, Tanya, recommended me buy this. I like it. I also like it just because it's small, so it doesn't take up a lot of room. But if you've got the long foam roller, grab it. And again, this is my foam rolling workout. This is sort of the routine that I do, right? I want it to be quick and I want to get into those muscles. So I start with my quads. So we're going to come on down. I'm basically going to be in a plank position. The foam roller is above my kneecap, so you don't want to put it on your joints. And all I'm going to do is just think of a plank for 1 second, engage my abdominal, squeeze the glutes, and I'm just going to roll through it. I'm going to roll back. So think joint to joint, but maybe not touching the joints. So all the way to the hip, right to the start of the knee, but not on the knee. Roll through it. So why are we doing this? This is myofascial release. You are basically trying to increase the blood flow and the circulation of the muscle. You're actually trying to hydrate the muscle by doing this. So not in the way we think of drinking water. So yes, you want to drink water, you want to hydrate. By just doing this foam rolling exercise, you are increasing blood flow and hydrating the muscle. So it's going to help your body perform better for you. I'm flipping to the side, IT band. So same thing, I'm going right above the kneecap. Opposite leg comes in front. You can have a bent knee, and then I'm gonna roll through it. You just wanna make sure you have some room. Ooh. So you're kind of elevated up in a side plank, right? If I relax all the way down, there won't be as much resistance on the muscle, and I want some resistance. I want to get deep into the tissues. So IT band. If you're a runner, this is your area that you really need to foam roll because you really need to get that blood flow, especially if you have knee pain. It probably means your IT band is tight. Ooh! Now you've probably heard if there's a spot where it hurts, you want to stay on that spot. Now sometimes it's really hard for me to stay on that spot. I just try to move through it. So right about here is my spot where it's tight. I'm just gonna roll through it, breathe. I'm gonna do one more pass and then I'm switching to the glutes and then I'll get to the other IT band. Woo! All right, so I'm gonna flip over. For the glutes, I'm gonna try not to fall off. I'm gonna stay sort of leaned on this side. And you can do this just with your feet grounded. But my favorite way is to take the leg, cross it over, and then roll through it. So we're getting through the gluteus maximus, the biggest part of your glute muscle. But also, I'm trying to get to the top and the outside of that glute, gluteus medius. If you do any band work, and if you do my lower body blast class, we do a lot of band work. These muscles tend to get tight. We're working them, that's good, but we want to foam roll them. And you can kind of hold it and then kind of move your leg in and out of it. So this is my left side. This side is pretty good for me. No pain, feels good. When I get to the right, I'm gonna have to stay there a little bit more and marinate. I'm gonna go right to the other side. So I'm gonna flip over. I'm actually gonna turn around so that my back isn't to you. Feels rude. So other side. So you're basically putting the weight of that glute on that foam roller and rolling through it. Feels good, but I know this is my tight side. I'm gonna have to spend a little more time on this one. I'm gonna cross the leg over. And just by doing that, it sort of adds to the resistance or the weight of your hip on that foam roller. So it's gonna get a little bit more dense. It's gonna get into the glute a little more. Ooh. Now right there, that's the spot for me. I have to breathe. So this is my right side, and my right side is my dominant, it's my strong side. So again, this is where I really need to foam roll and get some blood flow. This is what causes my lower back to be tight. This area right here. Now I'm gonna flip right to the other side, IT band. So find my balance. I might need to move this down so I don't hit. And then I'm gonna roll, kneecap, all the way. Ooh, I already feel that. Now I haven't run in a long time, but when I was running, this was extremely painful for me. And I had a lot of knee pain. Ooh, if you're a runner, this is important, even if you don't have pain. Ugh, keep that blood flowing. So I'm not flowing as much through this one. I'm kind of staying in little areas because I feel it tight. Ooh, mama. Ooh. So you listen to your body, stay on any of the points where you need to stay, any parts of your muscles, any parts of your body that are super tight. Ooh, I'm gonna do one more pass and then I'm excited to get to the hamstrings. All right, so hamstrings, I'm gonna flip over. Again, a lot of balance on this. So I'm starting, and I can start right up at the glutes. So pull your abs in, chest up, and I'm just gonna roll back. So I could do one leg at a time. I'm gonna end up doing that for my inner thighs. But this feels good just to do both hamstrings together. Ooh. Feels pretty good. My hamstrings don't feel that tight. Or at least there's no points where it hurts. So stay here a little longer if you need to. And then I'm gonna go to my least favorite one, but I know it's important. All right, so this one's gonna be a little bit awkward. I'm gonna flip over. We're trying to get into the inner thighs and the groin. So I set it up at an angle. And then I take the leg on top, so I'm targeting my inner thighs, and just let that foot drop for a second, make sure the knee is not on the foam roller. And then I'm lifting through the core, and then I'm just gonna roll through it. So think about going full inner thigh, right to your groin, and then come back. So inner thighs, it also gets a little bit into your hip flexor, or the psoas, which tends to get tight if you do a lot of squats and lunges. Ooh! So not gonna lie, this one's a little awkward. I know. It's a little awkward, but it's still good, it's still important. Ha, ha, mommy. One more pass. And then I'm going to the other side. Ooh! Other side. So again, setting it up is usually the most awkward thing. One side, for me, is easier to get into. And then I'm gonna roll. Inner thighs. Believe it or not, if you do a lot of lunges, your inner thighs do a lot of stabilizing with lunges. Roll through it. Woo. Just a couple more. And again, pulling those abs in. Almost mimicking a plank. One more pass. One kiss is all it takes. Okay, I skip this a lot, but we really shouldn't. Calves. And you could do both calves together, but I'm gonna do this single leg and be lifted. It's a little awkward. I like to flex my foot so that the calf muscle kind of pops out a little bit. Feels good. Now I could stay grounded. If I stay grounded, I just can't get as much resistance. If I lift, it's more body weight and it gets a little bit deeper into that calf muscle. My calves feel pretty good. I'm gonna switch sides. I'm up. you do a lot of cycling, if you do a lot of running, your calf muscles do a lot of work. One kiss is all it takes. Awesome. All right, another one that I do is sort of my upper back and my lats. Not gonna lie, these ones, they're a little bit awkward, but they can also get you to activate and balance and work your core. So right now I have it at sort of my mid back. I'm gonna hold it here and I'm just gonna lift up to a bridge. Oh, and that feels good. And I'm just gonna roll through that. Now you can take your hands behind your head. Just taking your hands behind your head might make you engage your abs a little bit more. Yes, so that's a good thing. So just roll through it. I just do a couple of inches right here. And again, I'm trying to engage my abdominals, staying with it. Ooh. Now maybe you can go a little bit further back, but this is gonna be some balance. Now I can drop my butt and roll through it, but then I have nowhere to move, right? So I'll give you another way to do that. I'm gonna come up and I'm rolling through it, walking through my feet. Oh, that feels good. So I don't go to my cervical spine. I go right to the upper back and then come back. Oh, that feels good. So I tend to have a tight lower back. This is me. And I know that it's usually because I have tight hips or tight glutes. So I tend to work on the foam roller with those. But in reality, it could be that my lats are also tight and that's pulling on my back. So I have to remind myself that the whole body is connected and we really should foam roll as many muscle groups as you can. A little bit of mobility, super, super important. And you see a lot of these exercises in my warm-up. So I'm gonna start just on all fours, wrists underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips. We're gonna do a rotation, thoracic spine. Super, super important that your thoracic spine is nice and mobile. Open up, and it's opening up through the front of the shoulder. Switch sides. Ugh. One more, feels good after I foam rolled. Now I'm gonna come to a plank. So holding the plank, you know why planks are good, right? They're good for core stability. So right now I'm staying super stable. I'm gonna take a breath. Exhale, pull the abdominals in. And now we're gonna do a little bit of balance for that stability. So take one hand off, tap the shoulder, tap the shoulder. You know I do these a lot in warm-ups. And then I usually superset it with a front lunge. So hold, take one leg up. You can add that twist, step back and switch. Come on up. So we're getting mobility through your thoracic spine, but also you're getting a hip flexor stretch. Switch sides. Hold it. Hold the plank, give me those shoulder taps again. You always have the option to drop your knees down. So remember, this is core stability. It's not just your abs, it's all the muscles from your shoulders to your hips. Can you try to keep your hips stable as you touch one shoulder? Now go back to that hip flexor, twist. Oh, that feels good. Switch. Oh, that feels good. Don't be afraid to hold it a little longer. Last one. Now I'm gonna step back, drop the knees, sit back in child's pose. Child's pose. I love to have my knees opened up, my hips back. I'm able to get a little bit deeper into the stretch. Now reach your arms out. So as I reach my arms out, I stretch through the lats and through the shoulder. Hold it. And then take both hands, walk them towards the right side and really feel the stretch in the left side body. Ooh, that feels good. Switch, walk to the other side. Yes. Take it back center. You can hold this child's pose a little bit longer. Drop the head if you like. So one more series that I love to do depending on how my body feels. So you're going to come up. So a little bit of yoga down dog, right? Why do we love down dog? I love it because it stretches the hamstrings and the calves. And it lengthens your spine. So take a deep breath. Inhale, bend the knees. Exhale, lengthen your legs, lengthen your spine. Do that again. Inhale, bend the knees. Exhale, lengthen. Oh, that feels good. Feels good. Now take your right leg up. Reach it up as high as you can. Oh my God, my hip just popped. Now draw the knee in. Come right to a pigeon. Hold it here. Ooh. Now pigeon, I like to stay up. If you like to come down into it. Try to keep your hips square. Yes. We're gonna move through this. Dig the toe again and step that leg right back and shoot the leg straight back up. You can bend the knee, open up the hip. Oh, that feels good. Bring the knee back in, sink right into pigeon again. One more time, this side. Dig the toe, lift, kick the leg out. Either hold it straight up or bend the knee, open up. Ooh. One more pigeon here. Draw the knee in, plant the leg. Breathe. We're gonna switch to the other side. So step back, first come to down dog, and then milk it here, stay here, marinate in it. Bend the knees, inhale. Exhale, lengthen your legs, lengthen your spine. Stay here again, take a breath, inhale, bend the knees. Exhale. Now as you lengthen your legs, I want you to think more about extending your tailbone up to the ceiling. Don't worry about your legs being straight. Now take that left leg up or the opposite leg. Ooh, reach. Draw the knee in, sink into that pigeon. Just notice how it feels on this side versus the other side. Honor your body. Again, you can be up or down. And then dig that toe again. Step back, kick the leg up. You can stay straight or bend the knee, open up. Oh, that's gonna get into that hip flexor. Draw the knee in, come back to pigeon, hold it. So if your body's nice and warm, and mine is from all that foam rolling, this feels really good. I feel mobile, I feel strong. Come on up. One last time, reach up, bend the knee, open up the hip. Breathe, breathe. Bring the knee back, come back to pigeon. Ooh, hold it. Finish it in down dog. So come on up, push those hips up, take a breath, bend the knees. Exhale, lengthen, hold it. How close can you get your heels to the floor? Take one last breath, inhale, bend the knees. Exhale, lengthen your legs. Drop your knees down, go into child's pose one last time. Ooh. Hopefully you feel great. Hopefully you feel stretched out, a little bit more mobile. Hopefully your joints feel a little bit more juicy and a little more lubricated. Remember, this does not have to be a 45-minute workout for you. It can be 5 minutes a day. It can be 10 minutes a day. Listen to your body.